Welcome to AETCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today we will be presenting an ankle case coming to ER. Shall we start the case, sir? 60-year-old male was brought into ER with a history of twisting his ankle in bathroom while walking. This is our initial history, and he is complaining of pain in ankle region. And on arrival, our initial parallel survey assessment, patient airway is patent, there is no signs of respiratory distress. Circulation BP is 140 on 80 millimeters of mercury, two large bore IV cannulas are issued, and pain score is 6 out of 10. So we offered an analgesic at this point. Patient said yes, and we gave paracetamol of 1 gram, IV stat was given, and we proceeded with primary assessment of parallel survey. In primary assessment, patient airway is patent. There is no features of airway obstruction like stridor, hoarseness of voice. There is no secretions in oral cavity. And C-spine movement is normal. There is no spinal line tenderness. In breathing, bilateral air entry is present. Vesicular breath sounds are heard all over lung fields. Respiratory rate is 20 cycles per minute. Saturation is 96% in room air. BP is 140 on 80 millimeters of mercury. All peripheral pulses are equally felt. Capillary refilling time is 2 seconds. Disability GCS is E4, V5, M6. Pupils are 3 millimeters, equally reacting to light. Temperature is 98.2 degree Fahrenheit. Sugars were checked at this point of time. It is 168 milligrams per deciliter. In primary survey management, patient is having problem in disability part, that is pain. We have managed it with paracetamol, and we are proceeding with sample history and secondary survey. In signs and symptoms, patient had a history of twisting his ankle in bathroom while walking, and he didn't fall. There is no history of head injury. There is no history of LOC seizure, ENT bleed or amnesia.
It's an isolated injury to the foot. Okay. So what is his age?
60, sir.
60-year-old. Okay. Fine.
These were his signs, and there is a swelling and pain was there in ankle joint. Patient is not having any allergies. Patient is known case of type 2 diabetes mellitus on metformin, and known case of hypertension on nebivolol 2.5 mg OD. And events leading to this history is patient while walking inside bathroom, he had twisted his ankle, and these things have happened. And in head to toe examination, there is no pallor, icterus, cyanosis.
Can we go to the local examination?
We will go to local examination directly, sir. In ankle examination, first our management starts with pain management, then gait assessment, then our inspection and palpation. In pain management, already we have treated. Now gait assessment. Because of pain, patient is not able to walk, so gait
assessment was
we are not able to do. And in inspection, we have to start from anterior, lateral, and posterior. Three aspects we have to start. In anteriorly, when we examine right leg, that injured leg is comparatively swollen compared to the opposite leg, and there is skin is stretched and shiny. In when we assess laterally, there is no fullness noted behind lateral malleoli, there is no.
What is the swelling exactly? It is more over the anterior or on the lateral medial?
Anterior to lateral malleoli area.
Okay.
Patient is having swelling.
So more over the lateral malleoli to the anterior aspect of the angle, he has got swelling. So medial malleoli?
Medial malleoli, he is not having swelling at the times.
Foot?
There is no swelling in foot, and he is able to move fingers properly.
Okay. After this injury, was he able to walk?
Sir, after this injury, from bathroom, he came to bed and he sat, sir. After that, he haven't moved his limbs.
He hasn't mobilized that limb. Okay. So it looks like a significant injury.
Yes.
That is one history, from the history what we can see. Usually, one of the commonest injury that we will get is an ankle injury in emergency department. The most commonly, it will be a sprain, ankle sprain. So what will be the classical history of ankle sprain?
If patient is having ankle sprain, patient usually will be having a twisting movement while walking. That will be the usual way of presentation. And most common ligament in ankle strain is anterior talofibular ligament, ATFL.
Okay. So I am asking regarding the clinical feature. Here, this patient had an injury and he is unable to walk. What is the classical history that you will get in sprain?
sir, mostly it will be an inversion injury. Mostly in the following this patient, gradually patient will develop the tenderness as well as swelling over the lateral aspect.
How fast it will happen?
2 to 3 hours.
Sir. Yeah, that's what. Sprain and all, it will take some time to develop the swelling. But usually the fracture, if anything is there, it will immediately, the patient will have the swelling. That is a basic difference. Sprain will take little bit time because each one of them would have had this episode. One sprain angle we would have had. Maybe we'll be walking for some time. After some time, we started thinking that it is started paining and we'll stop walking. So that is the one history.
Ankle sprain is of three types, sir. Type 1, 2 and 3. One, patient will be able to walk with pain, sir. Two, because of pain, patient won't walk. Type 3, there will be complete in ankle, complete tear of ligament, so that patient won't have pain. These are three.
Again, it depends upon, as you said, depends upon the extent of the injury. So the most common, as you said, it is the inversion injury.
Inversion
and injuries. Most common ligament involved is the
anterior talofibular
ligament. Anterior talofibular ligament. So the tenderness will be where exactly?
Lateral malleoli, anterior to lateral malleoli.
Anterior to the lateral malleoli.
Anterior inferior to
lateral. Anterior inferior to the lateral malleoli. Okay, fine. So again for this patient now is in front of you and he has got a swelling. Further to the inspection.
Yes, sir. In inspection, we did first, there is swelling and fullness noted, sir, and skin is stretched. And in palpation, we did, palpation is superficial and deep palpation. Superficial palpation, patient had warmth, sir. And when we palpate, he is having tenderness, sir. But first we palpated knee joint, then only because ankle joint is affected, we examine and confirm that knee joint is normal, then only we did ankle joint exam. Ankle joint, when we started to palpate, in medial malleoli pain is less there, but he is able to bear it. In lateral malleoli area, pain is still more excruciating.
So,
sir,
in an ankle injury, which are the bony prominence that you should palpate?
In ankle injury, usually six bony, ankle and tarsal injury, five bony prominence are there, which we should examine. One is medial malleoli, one thing is lateral malleoli.
Exactly in the medial malleoli where you should palpate?
In tip and anterior to medial malleoli, in lateral malleoli, inferior portion of lateral malleoli, and in talus we have to palpate, and navicular bone we have to palpate, and in fifth metatarsal we have to palpate, sir.
So these are the bony prominence that you have to palpate in an ankle injury or a foot injury. So, and maybe depends upon the mechanism of injury. If it is a fall from height, you have to look for calcaneal tenderness also. So these are the additional things. But obviously for this case also, you have to investigate, you have to palpate for the lateral malleoli tenderness, medial malleoli tenderness, base of the fifth metatarsal and also the navicular. These are the basic, and also the anterior aspect if you are looking for any ligamentous injury. But bony prominence, these are the bony prominence. So what happened to this palpation?
Patient is having tenderness in lateral malleoli area, sir. Both medial malleoli and lateral malleoli tenderness, more on lateral malleoli area. We couldn't palpate any crepitations, sir. And all other bony prominence, he is not having any tenderness, sir.
Okay.
And with completion for palpation, we did arterial palpation also. Dorsalis pedis artery is palpable and posterior artery is palpable. There is no sensory deficit in this patient, sir. And movements, since patient is having pain, we couldn't examine full range of movements, sir, after offering analgesic also. But usually if movements are, we are able to elicit movements, then it will be dorsiflexion will be 15 to 20 maximum and plantar flexion will be 50 degrees, sir. And inversion eversion. Eversion will be 15 degrees and inversion will be 30 to 35 degrees maximum we can check.
So when you are having such a palpation tenderness, better not to go ahead with further range of movements examination. What else you can you do some splinting at this point of time?
Yes, sir. We can do splinting, sir. And
after the examination, you can definitely go ahead with splinting.
We can offer cold compression also.
Yes.
And elevate the limbs also. Then before any of the plan for the imaging, before that we can plan for immobilization.
Okay. How you want to immobilize this ankle joint?
Yes, sir. Ankle immobilize, sir. Braces are there, which is ready-made, sir. Sizes will be medium, short, small, medium, and large based on weight, sir. And POP we can apply, sir. POP
POP after an X-ray, yes, it will be preferable. I am telling you, prior to the X-ray, the patient has come in front of you. You are given an analysis. You have done your examination. X-ray, it will take some time, maybe another 10-15 minutes. Or what type of splinting you can do?
Thomas splint you can use.
Thomas splint is needed.
Normal L-shaped
splint. Something that should be immobilizing the joint. And how should be, what is the principle of splinting? Basic principle.
One joint above and one joint below should be immobilized.
Ideally.
And in anatomy with the patient, we have to immobilize. And if we know the mechanism of injury, we have to do the exact opposite thing and keep in alignment of the fractured segments.
Okay. So, without X-ray, don't think of reduction or anything. You try to be keep in most possibly the anatomical position, the neutral position. That is what is acceptable. And one joint below and one joint above should be immobilized. That is the basic concept of splinting. And in any joint examination, as you said, what are the basic things that you have done is, one is in lower limb, we have to look for gait. For this patient, we couldn't assess the gait. Then you have done the inspection, which showed a swelling mostly in the anterolateral area. That is the swelling, nothing else was elicited, and no other hematoma, nothing else superficially you couldn't see. And coming to the palpation, there is tenderness over the lateral malleoli and medial malleoli. There is no other bony tenderness, and range of movements, it is painful, so we didn't assess much. So this is that inspection. So any special test for ankle joint as such?
Sir, special test, as we discussed, it is contraindicated in acute conditions, sir. Mm. But if pain is subsiding, we can try some tests. One is anterior dryer test. Anterior dryer test, usually we will with one hand we will hold lower part of tibia and fibula, and with other hand we will support tarsal bones, and we will try to immobilize it. We will try to move ankle joint anteriorly. If there is a giveaway, then there is anterior talofibular joint is involved.
More in sprained cases, we can do all these special tests. Yes. Otherwise, it is routinely when you are suspecting a fracture, it is not needed. Maybe special test is not going to give you much yield in this cases also. Even if it is a sprain, you want to immobilize. But when you come to a knee joint examination, definitely it is warranted. Because all the anterior drawer, posterior drawer, McMurray test, your all those things you have to do. You have to look for all your meniscal injuries and your collaterals, collateral ligament injuries. But in ankle joint, special test, in a sprain injury, if there is no much swelling, you want to rule out something, definitely you can do. For diagnosing, it might help, but not to that extent as you are doing it for your shoulder joint or for your knee joint. Okay. So, how did you proceed now?
Yes, sir. Now we have offered analgesia and we have examined, sir. We are suspecting ankle joint pathology, and whatever ankle rule we applied, sir. Whatever ankle rule patient is having tenderness in lateral malleoli, that 5 points are there, sir, which we have already discussed, yeah. That 5 bony tenderness. Mm. So, we did a X-ray, sir. X-ray we took.
What are the components of Ottawa rule?
Can you? Yes, sir. Ottawa ankle rule have ankle and tarsals rule have 5 components. One is tenderness over tip of medial malleoli or in front of medial malleoli, tenderness over inferior aspect of lateral malleoli, tenderness in navicular bone, tenderness in head of metatarsal bone, and patient not able to walk 4 steps in ED. Mm-hmm. This 5 points. Any one of them is positive, then we can do ankle X-ray.
Ankle X-ray.
This is having chance of this taking and ruling out. X-rays is 35% sensitive in this case, sir. And if X-ray, 3 X-rays we will do for ankle usually. One is AP, lateral and mortis view for ankle.
Lateral or oblique, which is oblique or mortis view. We can call it as oblique view, sometimes it can call mortis view. So which is the most important X-ray among this? I am telling you, can take one X-ray.
AP.
Lateral X-rays are ankle joint, always the best. Result you will get is from lateral X-rays. So definitely you have to take a lateral X-rays. AP view, the problem is that sometimes that overlapping everything will be there, we'll be missing it. So if you're able to take one X-ray, if you're able to take a lateral view, at least minimum lateral view, but ideally an AP, lateral and oblique, or you otherwise you call it as mortis view. Mortis view is involving that angle, joint completely. So the best thing is AP, lateral and oblique. Any joint you remember, you want to take AP, lateral and oblique. That is the best views that you will be able to elicit. Okay, what was the X-ray finding?
X-ray finding, this patient had bimalleolar fracture, sir.
Okay.
Weber's type B.
Weber's type B. Can you explain?
Yes, sir. Weber's classification is based on trans-syndesmotic, sir. If it is within 4 cm of the syndesmosis, it is...
How it is classified?
A, B, and C, sir. Mm. Weber's type C is below syndesmosis.
Infra-syndesmosis.
And type B is trans syndesmosis, and type C is above syndesmotic.
Supra, infra, trans.
Trans.
Okay, this is trans.
Trans, sir. Type
okay.
B.
Okay.
This was the X-ray finding, sir.
Mm.
And we got the patient back from X-ray rooms.
Okay.
And we planned for.
Now I am telling this patient pain is not subsiding. He is complaining of lot of pain in that ankle joint. So you are planning for some manipulation also, and how will you proceed now?
Yes, sir. Patient is in this patient, ideally we can, one is regional anesthesia we can go, sir. In regional anesthesia there is ankle block option and saphenous nerve block option and peroneal component of sciatic block we can use.
How good it will be ankle block for this patient?
In this patient, ankle block we can't use it because injury is also above ankle joint. So we have to combine it with something else. So better will be saphenous nerve block with popliteal blocks.
Popliteal block and all, how frequently we will be doing?
It is difficult
to do popliteal block. Ultrasound guided, it is a very deep seated structure. So instead of that, what else you can offer? Can you do it little bit above?
Femoral
nerve block can be tried. If it is of immense pain, femoral nerve block with further block downwards. Anything else you can do into the block, into the hematoma?
Hematoma block we can use, giving local anesthesia into the hematoma.
Okay.
That is hematoma block. Thing is, when we are going for blocks, usually we will use more amount of local anesthesia. Sir. So we have to give with adrenaline medicine, we have to prefer. Sir. And this for blocks and all, we will go deep. So sometime we may increase the dose also. For example, in ankle blocks, in popliteal block and all, we may require 10 ml. Usually we will give 5 ml.
Which drug you will select?
Lignocaine, 1% with adrenaline.
When you are going for regional anesthesia, which will be better agent? We have wanted to have an agent that has got longer action. Better than lignocaine?
Bupivacaine
is a little bit more long acting, so bupivacaine will be a little bit more preferred when you are coming. Lignocaine also can be given, bupivacaine we can give, that will be a better option. It will be long acting. Then
this will be pain management, sir. And after that we have to apply POP, and this patient type bimalleolar fracture will require surgical correction, sir, because chance of it going for malunion is very high in this case. So he requires surgical correction. Before that, we have to immobilize with POP and we have to shift. For applying POP from balls of toes to mid-calf level, we have to apply it. If we reduce the mid-calf level little bit below, chance of the POP slipping down is high. If we increase it more, then we won't be able to flex the knee joint. That is the problem. And usually we will take 14 to 16 rolls of 6-inch
thickness layers of POP we will take. And what will be the shape immobilization?
Either neutral or 15 degrees dorsiflexion we will keep for position of leg, sir. And before applying POP and after applying POP, you have to check for distal pulse.
Neurovascular deficit, anything is there or not. So how common is to have a compartment syndrome in this case?
Sir,
ankle injury.
Yes, sir. Ankle injuries are also more prone. So 10-15% chances are there. And usually what we'll think is ankle injury will have compartment syndrome only in foot. But chance of getting them in leg is also high, because minimal syndesmotic injury only we will see in ankle joint, and lateral malleolar fracture will be there. But because of that syndesmotic injury, this blood can track above and it can land up in leg compartment syndrome. In compartment syndrome, what we usually check is compartment pressure we will check, sir. If it is more than 10, we will directly label them it is compartment syndrome. But actually we have to calculate delta compartment pressure. Is systolic pressure minus compartment pressure. If it is more than 25 to 30, then it is significant, sir.
Okay. So what you have done for this patient now?
This patient, after giving analgesic, and we have immobilized, sir. That before that we will follow PRICE protocol, sir. That is pressure over the involved area, ice compression, rest and elevation. This we have to follow, and we have applied plaster of Paris.
Okay. So for any you are given drugs for reduction.
Sir, after something pain reduced to 1 to 2 scales.
Okay.
So
no other manipulation was not done. It was just fixed in the POP.
Yes.
Okay. Fine. So it was displaced or undisplaced?
Say it is undisplaced.
Undisplaced. So undisplaced bimalleolar fracture needs fixation. Why you need fixation?
If this fracture we are not going for over IF means once patient to start to walk, weight will be bearing through medial malleolar area, sir. So medial malleolar will move and patient will go for malunion, and chance of going for compartment syndrome is high, sir. Then CR, complex regional pain syndrome, chances is high in this kind of fracture.
Then you said he is a 60-year-old male.
Yes.
It is a trivial trauma, just a twisting of ankle in the bathroom. Why he should develop this fracture? We have to evaluate for that.
Osteoporosis.
And what will be the most common problems with the osteoporosis? Then what blood investigation you need to check?
Calcium.
calcium and vitamin D level, definitely you need to check. And definitely if any other symptoms either, you have to do for further workup for other malignancy or anything. We don't know why he developed a fracture like this. So definitely you need to evaluate for him that also. That is the one thing that commonly missed, that need to be followed up. They will be, fracture will be treated. Maybe again he is coming after a trivial fall with a neck of femur with a pathological fracture again. So we have to look for that, and you have to look for the vitamin D. Have it been checked?
No, sir.
Okay.
It was planned, sir.
Okay. Just make sure that it is being done prior to discharge. Vitamin D level. Okay. Anything to add on? That's it, no?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.